Good morning, guys. So I am wandering around my apartment, trying to figure out what to train and trying to figure out a workout for you guys to help you actually with straddle handstand because someone asked me. So I'm in the midst of blending up a smoothie before I work out. So I thought I would just give you some real perspective of everything. So I'm cutting up one banana. So there's a tip when you're eating bananas, and they say when you're eating a banana, never look someone in the face. There's awkward moments as adults. As kids, it doesn't matter, but we all have these perspectives. So one banana, and then, yeah, I'm kind of one of those people that cleans as I go, so you have to bear with me. after that, I'm going to my fridge, and I'm putting some half a milk. I do drink normal milk, but I actually like to change it up. I find that I have a sensitive stomach, but I try and drink normal milk to make sure my stomach doesn't get non-accustomed to it. Sorry about the lighting. Doesn't get non-accustomed to it, that I can't drink it at all, that I can still have snippets of it. So that helps me not to get sensitive. I try and keep the sensitivities away. And one of the reasons people get very sensitive is because they often take out foods that aren't necessarily needing to be taken out at that moment. So I try to make sure I've learned through growing up not to do that. And yes, this is an apple pie. And yes, I had a piece last night. Homemade from a friend. So this is protein. The reason I am drinking some protein in the morning at the moment is I found I'm extremely tired and I wanted to get a little bit more energy through to myself. I didn't want to use training supplements that give energy, but like sometimes putting some caffeine or green tea into it, but I find that I'm very sensitive to training products. They can bring on depression, anxiety, and I don't want to have to deal with that. They also affect your skin as well. I have really sensitive skin. They always break me out. This is one teaspoon of cocoa. Anybody guess? I like chocolate. I made a kind of idea for me with chocolate, that if I have a chocolate drink, then I don't really want to eat too much chocolate. I do eat chocolate sometimes, but not so much anymore. One teaspoon of shredded coconut, that always seems to go everywhere. And one teaspoon of peanut butter. And one more thing, yes, one more thing. This all seems very exciting, okay. My parents are coming in a few days, so I won't be able to do as many lives. I'm going to focus on spending time with them, and I don't want to film. They probably don't want to be filmed on camera, so I have to be mindful of other people, but I will definitely share whatever I can. The last thing was, yes, I remember now. Approximately a teaspoon, I'm just going to shake it in, of linseed, great dietary fiber. Sometimes with protein, we lack dietary fiber, so I always add a little sprinkle in, just to give your body a kickstart. And that is about it. And now I'm going to blend it up. Let's get it noisy in here. But I do add it when I need it, and then you drink it. And you can add some cocoa nibs or some chai seeds if you want to as well. And that's basically how I start my day, to get like
to get some energy before I train, or just to re-supplementally kind of energize my body. After training also is an option, so it depends, either before training or after training I take it, depends when I have it. These are the cocoa nibs. Yep, getting fully chocolatey today. And these are the chai seeds in German, so they're great for when you want to meet someone and you drink this stuff and then you smile and you say, have I got something in my teeth? So I am sitting here actually at the moment working out my workout, and I am drinking this and then I'm going to train. And so at the moment I wanted to share how to get some skills to straddle press, because some people have asked me. So I'm just trying to share little pieces of me. I of course have limitations. We can't see everything. It's not a reality TV show, but just to show you it's a normal everyday life. And yes, again, I tend to not train in a lot, reason being in Switzerland. We one reason is that we only have washing once a week, and I only train once a day, but the clothing does add up to the washing. I already have around 6 loads at the end of the week, and so if I always had my training products, training clothes, it would be a hell of a lot more, and I just not into it. I was also an athlete and I swam and ran a lot. And we didn't wear a lot of clothes, so I don't really think about it. Social media tends to put the stigma on it. But if you look at runners, they often run in a knicker and a bra. Distance runner I was. Swimmers often wear swimsuits. So, you know, it's all a perspective. It's just that social media allows us to place this perspective upon it. And the last thing was, I taught myself how to train. And through teaching myself how to train, I had to understand where my muscles were activating. And when you cover it up with clothing, I couldn't see if my hip flexors were activating or my core was activating or my glute muscles. And often glute muscles don't activate. And when they don't activate, they can cause back injuries or hamstring injuries. So it was a way of teaching me how to activate them as well. So I'm going to say cheers to you guys. Thanks for joining me for... I don't know what you call these things, but just a little share. Sending lots of love for a beautiful new day. Ciao.